thanksgiving the joining of Vivian and Rupert in the covenant of marriage and to ask God's blessing upon them. Marriage is a gift. It's a gift of God and a means of God's grace. God's gift of love and joy is given so that wife and husband may know each other with mutual care and companionship at all times. They are linked to each other's families and they begin a new life together in this community. And so this afternoon, this celebration is one of great joy, but it's also one of great seriousness. For you who have gathered here have helped shape their lives. You have helped them become friends and families and to know them well. Let us pray. Gracious God, always faithful in your love for us, we rejoice in your presence. We ask that you bless the love which Vivian and Rupert proclaim this day, and that their love and care for one another may ever deepen. May the power of the Holy sustain them and all of us in the love that knows no end. Amen. Amen. Rupert and Vivian, you have made it known that you wish to be joined together in marriage, and so I ask, Rupert, will you have Vivian to be your wife? And will you pledge your faithfulness to her in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with her and cherish her in the holy bond of marriage? Vivian, will you have Rupert to be your husband? And will you pledge your faithfulness to him in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with him and cherish him in the holy bond of marriage? I ask now that the parents of Vivian and Rupert to please stand. Do you, the parents of this wonderful couple, give them your blessing and promise to uphold and care for them in their marriage?
We do.
I'm going to invite everyone to please stand. No one comes to this place in their lives alone. Rupert and Vivian have built into the very fabric of who they are the caring, the nurturing, and the loving given to them by so many people. The meaning of the covenant that they make this day depends upon their ability to share and to give. And their capacity to share and to give they learned from their own families and from their friends. And so the value of the vows that they make today depends upon their capacity to make commitments and to keep faith. And so even more now, they need parents and a grandparent to understand. Even more now, they need a sister and a brother who are always there. And even more now, they need friends who listen and sometimes reflect back what they themselves may not hear. This new family that Rupert and Vivian are creating together must find its place, loved and supported within the world, a world that forms the very framework of God's love. And so, as their families and friends, do you accept the covenant to be made this day? And do you recognize your responsibility for joining a new relationship with them? If so, please answer, we do.
We do.
And you may be seated. Our first reading comes from Philippians, and all of our readings were chosen by Vivian and Rupert. Therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from his love, if any common sharing in the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, that make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and of one mind, do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourself, not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of the other. In your relationship with one another, have the same mindset as Jesus Christ. And then from the Sermon on the Mount, when Jesus stood in an amazing part of Israel and used these words, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me. Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven. Amen. Jeffrey, I'm going to ask you to come up.
This passage from Ecclesiastes, which Vivian and Rupert have chosen, illustrates the importance of Christian companionship. Two Christians that are bound together in Christ are stronger than the individuals themselves. This afternoon is more about simply uniting Vivian and Rupert as husband and wife, but also about entering a covenant relationship with each other and with God. As I read from Ecclesiastes, Vivian and Rupert will join together these three strands as a symbol of the intertwining of their lives with the love of God. From Ecclesiastes 4, verses 9 through 12. Two are better than one, because they have good return for their labor. If either one of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them get up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken.
We come here this afternoon to share this celebration, a celebration that we've all been waiting for. I first met Vivian a number of years ago when Winnie married my nephew Jeffrey. In many ways, almost instantly, Winnie and Vivian became a part of our family. And then a couple years ago, I traveled to China, and who should my roommate be but Vivian? A wonderful roommate she made also. But she kept emailing someone. And then I met Rupert. And Rupert actually traveled to Canada and came to our lake and had a sail. And so it was a delight when I was asked to come here, travel across the ocean and be a part of this wonderful day for two wonderful people. When I looked around last evening and today, and I noticed how far people have traveled to be here, you have come from all parts of the world. We live in a large world, but some ways it's very small. We live in a world that is busy. We live in a world that keeps us going. And so I want to ask the two of you to be careful. Don't get caught up in a world that feeds us daily of what we should strive for. Because sometimes we can forget the most precious things of all, faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. I know, Vivian Rupert, there will be times when you misunderstand each other, times when one demands too much of the other. But the growth of love is not a straight line. It's a series of hills and valleys, and there will be desert times. But remember, on the other side, there will be an oasis far more lush and far more loving than you could even believe. And remember, marriage does take dedication, a dedication to each other, but the rewards are tenfold. For marriage truly is a gift from God and a gift filled with love. Vivian and Rupert, there is nothing more wonderful in the human story than to look into the eyes of another person and see that love and that grace in the other's eyes. You are blessed beyond measure in your love for one another. Never take it for granted, and know always that you will be surrounded and supported by the friends and family that are gathered here and those who are not able to come. May you always know the peace of Christ, the love of God, and the comfort of the Holy Spirit each and every day of your lives. Amen. And now Megan has a wonderful piece to share.
I carry your heart with me. I carry it in my heart. I'm never without it. Anywhere I go, you go. Whatever is done by owning me is your doing. I fear no fate, for you are my fate. I want no world, for beautiful, you are my world. And it's you, or whatever a moon has always meant, and whatever a sun will always sing, is you. Here is the deepest secret nobody knows. Here is the root of the root, and the bud of the bud, and the sky of the sky of a tree called life, which grows higher than soul can hope or mind can hide. This is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart.
And now before inviting Vivian and Rupert to exchange vows, let us pray. Loving and beloved God, we pray for the presence of your spirit with Vivian and Rupert. Fill their hearts with love, with faith, with sincerity, as they enter this covenant today. Amen.
In the presence of God. In the presence of God, and before these witnesses, I, Vivian Hsu, take you, Rupert Stephen St. Ledger Moore, to be my husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, in joy and in sorrow, to love and to cherish, as long as we both shall live. This is my solemn vow.
In the presence of God, and before these witnesses, I, Rupert Stephen St. Ledger Moore, take you, Vivian Hsu, to be my wife, and to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, sickness and health, joy and sorrow, to love and to cherish, as long as we both shall live. This is my solemn vow.
Bless, O God, the giving of this ring, that those that as she wears it, it may live its faithfulness and love all their days, through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen.
I give you this ring, Vivian.
As a sign of our covenant.
As a sign of our covenant.
And all that I am.
And all that I am.
And all that I
have. All that I have.
I commit myself to you.
I commit myself to you.
I accept this ring.
I accept this ring.
As a sign of our covenant.
As a sign of our covenant.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I commit myself to you.
I commit myself to you.
What greater thing is there for two human souls than to feel that they are joined together, to strengthen each other in all labor, to minister to each other in all sorrow, to share with each other in all gladness, and to be one with each other in the silent, unspoken moments. And so, for as much as you, Vivian Rupert, have consented together in this sacred covenant and have declared the same before God at this gathering of family and friends, I pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. You may kiss the bride. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for the gift of your love and for the joy which Vivian and Rupert find in each other and for the love and trust with which they enter into the sacred covenant of marriage. Surround them with the constant consciousness of your love and will, that the vows now taken may be faithfully and joyfully fulfilled and the home here established be a place of inner peace and complete devotion to each other and to you. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Vivian and Rupert, you have come here today to unite your lives in loving commitment. You have come from separate backgrounds with your own unique personalities, your own strength, and your own needs. Your ancestors come from different parts of the world with their own incredible stories filled with love, stories that reflect the amazing and wonderful global world in which we live. We have a few stones here that have traveled here by friends and relatives, and they represent your separate lives. Together, as you find these stones, we're not sure where they all are now, as you find them and gather them together in a glass container, let it be a sign of your commitment. If you have stones, perhaps you could hold them up because we're all over the place.